Hard work, ingenuity and ambition. All things you'll find in abundance amongst the 15 million people of Shanghai over there to our southeast. And we've got plenty of that here on the grid as well. 20,000 horsepower, give or take, chomping at the bit to be unleashed for the Chinese Grand Prix. Shanghai International Circuit then, a 16-corner high-speed thrill ride. The long and ever-tightening right-hander at turns 1 and 2 tests a driver's patience, and the flat, open to the element's location, tests their skill in a crosswind. Two DRS zones will assist passing, and overtaking is available into turn 1, and of course down the kilometre-long back straight into the hairpin at turn 14. Joining me once again to take you through this race is the effervescent Anthony Davidson, and I'm very much looking forward to it getting underway. You raced here, of course, didn't you, back in your Super Aguri days in that infamous Chinese Grand Prix of 2007?
Yeah, that's right. I didn't last that long though, unfortunately. Qualifying had gone pretty well, but my brakes failed quite early in the race, around lap 10 or 11, something like that. And of course, back in 2004, I was the very first Formula One driver to complete a lap of this circuit. Just thought I'd mention that for you, Crofty. You like a good stat. It's a fairly tough circuit on the brakes here, though. You know, it's that long back straight down into turn 14, and then you got turns 6 and 11. They're quite heavy as well. On top of that, managing your front tyre wear is always a challenge around here, so there's a lot to keep in mind during the Grand Prix.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start. entering lap 3 now. DRS has been enabled. Of rain now. If the situation changes, we'll let you know. considering switching to an alternate strategy? Do you want to change or stick to plan A? Strategy change available to us. Would you like to keep to the current plan or try the new one? front. Appear, then we'll let you know. Just got the lead. Okay, gap ahead is 2.1 seconds. Fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Fastest lap of the race so far. at, they've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. Flags ahead. No overtaking through the caution zone. Be careful until you see the greens. So the gap to our teammate is 27.6 seconds. Changes. In first place. Places 1.0 seconds. available to us. Would you like to keep to the current plan or try the new one?
Thank you.
is open. The pit window is open.
Leader.
excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down. We'll be right back. better car in front is 5.6 seconds. Of rain now. If the situation changes, we'll let you know. Be aware, there's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags. Seconds. In front. Okay, gap ahead is 4.1 seconds. Paul's just moved into first place. Speeding up again, so I expect they've fixed whatever the problem was. Our gap to the car in front is 4.9 seconds. In first place. Seconds. 6 seconds. The gap to the car ahead is 6.2 seconds. If a storm front does appear, then we'll let you know. 4 seconds. Okay, gap ahead is 8.2 seconds. In first place. Seconds. Flags ahead. No overtaking through the caution zone. Be careful until you see the greens. seconds. To remain dry for a while, we will update you if the outlook changes. Finishing time at the end of the race. The gap to the car ahead is 6.5 seconds. Places 10.6 seconds. About a lap's worth of spare fuel in the car. You won't be able to run in mix 3 for long with that much, but do burn it if you need to. front is 6.0 seconds. The gap to the car behind is 11.7 seconds. Strategy. Do you want to change or stick to plan A? Out in front. Seconds. Again. So the gap to our teammate is 55.6 seconds. Switching to an alternate strategy. Do you want to change or stick to plan A? Okay, copy that. fastest lap for the race. Some information on Verline. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car. Okay, at this rate, we'll finish with a little extra fuel, so you have some in hand to run a faster engine mode for a bit. Seconds. The gap to the car ahead is 11.1 seconds. Of fuel remaining. Seconds. We'll be right back. 30.3 seconds. The gap behind us is 4.5 seconds. There's four laps of fuel remaining. Whatever the problem was, they're coming back up to speed. Okay, gap ahead is 15.1 seconds. Of rain now. If the situation changes, we'll let you know. job. You did really well. Super driving.
So, another excellent win from Ferrari. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
And as we can see, it's time for the podium. And as the drivers make their way out, there's a familiar red suit making its way to the top step. Fantastic win for Ferrari. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Well, the lead at the top has come down after a poor result for our points leader. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Lots of drivers impressed me today, Crofty, but I'd say the one who impressed me the most was Daniel Ricciardo.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. We saw a dip in form from the championship leaders today. Their lead has taken a significant blow. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time.